Hey everyone, Flying Dutchie here. Welcome to a new EU forum in the Emperor patch and 1.30.3 patch here. So welcome to Holland. We are going to try to form the Netherlands, and in this run we will try something different. Instead of blobbing all the way around, I am going to try to play tall. And I choose the Holland for this because I think that Amsterdam here is the best province in the game to develop. And why is that? Well, let me show you my spreadsheet that I made for this campaign. All the rules, all the things that we are going for is listed over here. So you can see on the left the development stacking. With all these things that we can get kind of easily, I would say, we can get a minus 145%. And as Amsterdam, make Amsterdam the capital, we can do a decision to get 25% bonus from the land reclamation. And of course, when you have 1,000 development countrywide, you get another minus 50. So you can get a total of minus 220% in Amsterdam if you make it your capital. And that's what we are going to do. That's not the only thing I'm going to do. I will also go and play with the Marines, because that is a new unit type that you can get as, well, a colonial nation, I would say. The only way to get Marines as the Netherlands is to complete your naval ideas. The Dutch idea 4, so a national idea of the Dutch, is also giving 5%. And there's a policy of the maritime and economic policy. It's also get 5%, so we can get 15% Marines. And the Marines manpower are the sailors. So the sailors that you have way too much of later in the game now have a usage. You can make troops from it. And that's what we are going to do. The idea groups, I actually doubt it a bit with innovative start or economic start. And I choose to not pick innovative. And that's because otherwise the idea groups come too late that I want to use. So we will start with economic that we need for the development stacking. And then we go with exploration expansion to colonize, of course. And then we take quantity so we can get another policy for another minus 10% development cost. Then we need the maritime and naval for the Marines. And yeah, I also took humanist in because the Dutch have a really good national idea set to get a lot of tolerance to other religions. So that's why I picked it on the fifth spot, not earlier, because we need to use the quantity as well. And the last idea is quality, but yeah, it's maybe not even gonna happen. Maybe we will end the run. There's not a big goal. I just want to be a huge colonial empire. And yeah, in the bottom you can see the example for Amsterdam. So if we go from 40 to 41 development and we did all these things, you can see that it will only cost 27 development to upgrade from 40 to 41. But that's for later. So yeah, we will keep the spreadsheet up to date. I will put things to green when they are active and when we can get it. And yes, so that's going to be the goal for this run. Let's go back to the game screen here. So the first things first, Holland needs to break free from Burgundy. Now, I did make a new start because in my first try, Burgundy did not rival France or Austria, so you cannot get free at all. But for now, we can get Aragon to help, and France is also very close. So first thing we need to do is improve with France. Hopefully he will help. I will sell my transports. We don't need them. We are going to make a huge fleet as the Netherlands. Because let us show us our Dutch ideas here. We have a national sailor modifier of 25% and naval force limit of 50%. And when we finish everything, we get trade efficiency. So with all these ideas, we are going to get a huge wooden fleet everywhere. We are going to get hundreds of ships everywhere. It's going to be amazing. Let's go over the ideas real quick. We have an yearly inflation reduction. We get a merchant. The polders, which is a minus 10 development cost modifier. That is really nice for us because we want to get as many modifiers as possible. Here you get naval leader fire plus 2, and the marines force limit is 5%. But this is, I think, the first way to get marines for us. Then here is the humanism, the plus 3 heretics. So that's why I took humanist ideas. Compared with this one, we will make the heretics accepted. We have siege ability and we have land fire damage plus 10. So they are not that bad. But I don't know if these change when you form the Netherlands. I think these will stay. But I'm not sure anymore. So that are the Dutch ideas that we're gonna go for. Well, the estates here. I think that I'm gonna get the plus 1 monarch power from all the estates at the start. We will go minus 20 or maybe even 30% taxation, but who cares, right? Our income is trade, not taxation. Well, a little bit. So I will take the plus 1 power from all the estates here. Not enough crown land. Oh, we have to seize land. We can do this because we are at 50%. Now everything is at 30%. And now we can pick this one as well. So we have almost no crown land anymore. Almost 5%. But at least we get plus 1 monarch power that we can use to develop. So that's really nice. Other things I'm going to take from this one is of course the oversight. Just to get a plus 10 loyalty equilibrium. And maybe I will go for the administrator cost here. But I will do this when we have a new king. Because we will lose some stability. So I first want to go back to plus 1 stability. And then we will do these ones. So for the nobility, we are going to take the rights of council and also the supremacy of the crown, so we can get a diet anytime. And the loyalty goes up with 10% for every estate. There we go. And then later on, also the military advisor cost, I think, or maybe this one. But we will see. And the burghers, we are going to take enterprise for the 10 and 10. The light ship power cost and trade power, absolutely very important for us because we are going to make hopefully a lot of trade income. And later on I will pick the advisor cost down, minus 25%, but not now. So yeah, we will have minus 20% taxation. We will have some autonomy change that goes up, unfortunately, but I think it's worthwhile to get the plus 1 point. Okay, we're gonna sell you. You guys can start protecting trade in the English Channel. For people that are new to the game, we are in the English Channel. And you can see that England has a couple of centers of trade and the estuary, the Thames. He has these ones as well. We only have on the level 2 in Amsterdam that will make a level 3 for the development modifiers. And we have the Rhine estuary. And we will try to get Antwerpen here for this center of trade and Brugge and Calais. And also the Ems estuary, which is part of this node. So yeah, the plan is to expand to these centers. And maybe a little bit here as well. Maybe I will go into Denmark. I will for sure go into England. So you can see a Dutch empire reaching from here to here, I think. Some sort of box here. Maybe some German land as well. But we will stay pretty tall. Okay, I think that we are done. I will ask, well, if I click this one, I think they won't, I think France won't like me anymore. So I will wait for France and then I will try and ask him to help me to break free. Hopefully everything will go all right. I will tell the AI that I want this land already. If there's coming a war, then we can at least take it. I should not make France unhappy with taking the same land that he wants. Apparently he doesn't like Calais. England wants Flanders right now. Maybe we can ask England to help as well. So I think I'm gonna ask for something like this in the beginning. Yeah, so it's gonna be a really interesting run with the marines and the development cost modifiers. Now Denmark over here, can I sell you my ships? Yes, and he would pay 10 for each. That is fantastic. So, there you go, Denmark, there's your fleet. In the beginning, we will not have enough sailors to maintain our ships. We're using 10 ships. They use one sailor for each lightship, I think. And we can only have 13. So when we have 13 ships, we use all our sailors that we get. But yeah, we have to build those dock buildings. Now let's pause the game. I will also improve with Austria. Maybe we can get relations high enough that he won't demand unlawful territory. And in the meantime, we will do this. We will lower our maintenance and try to make some money. Not gonna take any advisor. Now let's wait with assigning the focus, because we don't know which ruler we get when we break free. Now we have to see if we can get France on our side. I can build some troops. Now it is really risky what I'm doing here. Oh yeah, we have to stop building the ships first. Otherwise we don't get the troops, because they can really stack wipe my army. If I don't get support from France, we will just get wrecked over here. And then we have to wait for France to help us out. So I don't know what's gonna happen. But I hope to become free. Plus Antwerpen. Antwerpen. I will just keep using the Dutch names, I guess. Sounds really weird to use the English name as a Dutch guy. So I'm just gonna pronounce the Dutch names. So prepare for some sounds. Yeah, that's gonna take some time, I think. Let's go to speed 7. Yeah, we. Oh, shoot. England declared war on France. Restoration of Union happened. So now we have to wait until they are done with their war before we can break free. Now I can do two things now. I can restart or continue. Let's see how long this war is gonna take. Maybe this war won't take that long. And on the other hand, we can really start building our fleet up. So not such a big deal, maybe, that we have some time. And our ruler is really good. I mean, we have a 5-5-5 ruler that we can take advantage of. So maybe we'll just keep going. I will not increase my stability because we will lose it. And on the other hand, does it matter? Because when we break free, we lose one, and that will also cost 100. So you know what? Let's go to 1 stability and let's focus on admin, because our first idea group will be economic. I was hoping to break free really quickly, but it looks like we have to wait a bit. This war was just too early. Yeah, of course, these will all become my rivals: Gelre, Utrecht, and Friesland. It's gonna be some sort of role play as well, I think. Well, I don't know. Maybe I should just colonize whatever I can. I don't know. We will see. Most important is the development stacking. Now, come on, England and France, peace out. I think this is gonna take at least a couple of years. The Great Bullion Famine. The first European power to secure a new source of gold will reap great benefits. All right. Think I'm just gonna keep building ships. Just keep them docked if we use too much sailors. There's the Kingdom of Italy and the Empire. It's event for the Emperor. He needs to reign in Italy. And when he doesn't, this will all leave the Empire. And I think that's gonna happen, because they really nerfed down the Emperor in a good way. Now let's see how much trade we make now. We made 3.6. Yeah, we make almost 3.9. because of our fleet. Yeah, you can see it over here. England has way more trade power. And that's because of London having 42 trade power. Our best trade province is Den Haag, or The Hague International, and Amsterdam with 18 only. So yeah, we have to upgrade these to level 3, and we need marketplaces. And we need to develop the province. Because for every development you do, you get trade power. Every one click gives 0.2 trade power base on a base. Doesn't matter in which category. But if you have a 50 development level 3 center of trade, you have a huge amount of base trade power. Then with marketplaces you get a percentage bonus. And then you get a huge amount of trade. I don't care about the Pope. We are gonna go Protestant. Let's do this. Would you maybe help me? Oh, Austria likes Burgundy. Really? Well, at least we have a peaceful start this time. Small change. Yes, we will take the extra power for inflation, because inflation is just a number. How much is it to expand? I think it's 1,000 to upgrade this thing. Yeah, we need 1,000 for a world port or whatever it is called. So I'm just gonna sit on my money. Well, actually, I should keep building a couple more. Just to our force limit for now. I did not show you the mission tree yet. The Netherlands has a new mission tree that I will try to complete. This is the Holland mission tree. And I think these will get replaced for Netherlands or some extra stuff. The first things we need to do is get all the provinces in Holland, Flanders, South Brabant, North Brabant and Frisia. Then we get some bonuses here. Then we need to go to Wallonia, take those Wallonian provinces, huge amount of ducats and admin power, and then we need to become Protestant. Then we get the missionary strength. That goes to the Leiden University. Then we have this one. We need to have 4 core provinces, so I hope to get this with Antwerpen. Then we need 50% of Castile's naval strength, which we already have right now. Then we can complete this mission for 15 years of ship durability and morale of navies and navy tradition. And then we need good forts, 3 forts of the highest level. Some bonuses. We need 20 lightships. And we need 50 naval tradition. And then we get Pieter Post. Posts, what a name, a 4433. These are generic missions, Imperial Ambition. And when we are done here, we can do support the bulk trades. We need 32% of trade in Lübeck. Then we get an explorer. So this is an easy way to get an explorer without using your diplo points. And then we go into Ivory Coast, very important. The Leiden University gives a small bonus here. We chartered the VOC, the Verenigde Oost-Indische Compagnie. The WIC, the West-Indische Compagnie, which is in Guinea. Indonesia and Malacca. We have to see Ceylon, found Batavia over there. Conquer Malacca, Dutch Formosa. Indonesia, of course, a lot of Indonesian. Brazil, North America, Australia. Coromandel in India, colonize the Cape and the Caribbean. So it's a huge mission tree already, but we will get the Netherlands tree, which is a little bit different. So we just run on speed 4. I hope that this war will be over soon. I really do. I could also start claiming, so we have to spend less points, but meh. Who also likes to help me? Yeah, we should improve with Aragon. Maybe they will help me as well. Let's complete these ones first. Estate statutory rights. Oh my god. Oh yeah, this is what happens when you get when you have less crown land. Princes of Holland have come forth offering a compromise to Duke Philippe III. Seized land will be unavailable as long as estate statutory rights privilege is in effect. So when we take this one, we are gonna go and seize land of our clergy, nobility, and burghers. But we get 25 minimum autonomy. Is it in every province? Well, we are still small. Maybe it's a good idea to actually pick this one. I've never picked this one before because I always solved it ourselves by seizing land every 5 years. But this actually solves the whole problem immediately. So let's try this. Yeah, there we go. Now the whole thing is done, and we can revoke this one when? In 1467. Maybe that was a good idea, actually. I mean, all the problems are solved, suddenly. I don't know. Yeah, there's the autonomy. Except for the capital? Except for the capital. I think that was a good idea. Taxation is at least almost 2 ducats. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I think it doesn't matter that much. The curry control has picked the golden bull. We have development cost -5. I did not put that one in my list. But it will go away. Because when we are not Catholic anymore, we were not going to use this one. So that's unfortunate. I also forgot that there is a burger privilege, I think, that makes you develop your centers of trade cheaper. At least I have seen this one when I played Castile. I don't see it here right now, but maybe it comes later. I think so. Now, France is going to win the war. Surprise, surprise. Now, France, come on. Peace out. Two more ships. So we have 15 ships. That is our force limit right now. Not really high. But it will grow like crazy in this run. At least that is the purpose of this whole run, right? Getting a lot of sailors and make them into marines. If I would develop now, we already have -5 from the Pope, Farblands, Cloth, and Entrepot, and of course the Edict. The encourage development, so we can already get a cheap development growth in Amsterdam. And I want this to be my capital. And we could do that right now, because when I form the Netherlands, I don't think Amsterdam will become the capital. But I'm not sure. Amsterdam needs to become the capital. Very important. Okay, we are done with the relations here. I will improve with the Pope so he can't excommunicate me. The other one, let's improve with Aragon here, because they all want me to support as well. English pretender rebels. Come on, France, you need to peace out so we can do the war. How long will the AI fight this war? Oh, really? The game is already trolling us. Already trolling us. I want to be +1 stability because then we get prosperity. So I guess I have to click again. We have minus 10 because our leader is calm. Well, let's make use of it. Maine is occupied by English pretender rebels. Crazy. There should be a stable government. Lose prestige. We are going to lose prestige anyway. Now, France, are you going to peace out? If this takes too long, I will start over. Okay, we have a terrible leader now. Duke Charles. Horrible. And Aragon lost Naples, which they do almost every run in this patch. Yeah, and France, hurry up. Help me. He wants to help me. Anyone else? No, that's gonna be it. It will be France and Aragon, or maybe only France. We get a skill level 2 master of the master recruiter. Meh. Are we at our maximum manpower? Yeah, let's build an extra unit. When we break free, our force limit will go to 10 instead of 7. So let's make use of our manpower. Yeah, we are losing sailors like crazy because of our autonomy. And Burgundy declared war on Liège. Not good. Can I break free when we are at war? I think we can, right? I don't think so. So we have to wait for another thing to be ready. Oh god, it's gonna be a slow start this way. Slow on one side, but also good on the other side. I think we're gonna go to speed 5 now. We can tech up. I think there is no reason to wait, because when we are ahead of time, we get trade efficiency, which is really helpful for us. So let's pick it. Make lots more money when we have this. France is still not out of this war. I think we are the first one with tech 5, because we got 2 innovativeness from this. I don't think we're gonna reach 100 innovativeness in this run. Especially not because we are not taking innovativeness. No! Run. Well, we were at full manpower, so it's not the worst. I think Burgundy is gonna lose. I wish I could break free right now. And we can take this and also get innovativeness for how long more? 84 days. I'm gonna take it now. Oh, we have 4 innovativeness already. Hooray! And we have plus 20% production efficiency. Not really helpful. The start of the game. Let us build the marketplaces in our trade provinces. This is taking a long time. Almost too long. Yeah, you can lose prestige, that is no problem. And France is still not done with his war. Okay, England is France is done with England. England will see Maine, Alençon, Co and Caen. And Cotentin, I think. There we go. except for Bordeaux. Now, I want to ask you to help me. Here we go. And I think Aragon doesn't like this, or does it matter? Does it not matter? It doesn't matter. So we have Aragon and France to help us to break free. Can we do this? We can break free. Okay, then I'm gonna go and continue. Because this is, of course, the best moment to break free. Are we gonna get out of this war? That is my question. We have great relations. Really? Are we gonna lose 2 stability because we cannot get lower than 100? Oh no. Gonna build a couple more troops there. I mean, we will fight these over here. But what will happen with the war I'm in right now? Will we just skip that war or... What is gonna happen? Minus one. Is there no way to get lower relations? Maybe ask something that they don't want to agree with or something. For example, no, I can't even... Wait. I can't ask them. I don't think I can. Well, looks like we're gonna lose one stability. I don't see anything else I can do to lower relations. Let's go for it. Let's wait for this one to be out of my province. Where are you gonna go? Okay. Boom. Because union ended. We have a 3-5-4. Oh my god, what a good ruler. A new count. Eberhard I van Heemskerk. We are now at war with Burgundy and Franz Aragon are helping. So I'm not at war with the other ones anymore. I think that was the best thing to do. This was fantastic. Again, we have to boost our stability. Twice. So we click that button 3 times soon. Do I want to make you into a general? I mean, you're a really good ruler. I don't want you to die. Let's not do that. Let's make a normal ruler. General. And we have a 2 shock, so it's not bad. Not bad start here. I will ask people to join me. Where's my fleet? Fight. Let's see what I can do here. I should go here. Oh, are we gonna fight these now? Nope. Am I sieging this province? No, it is Hungary. It could go to Liège and then we have a problem. If this province go to Liège, then we lose a lot of trade power that I want at the start. Let's siege down some things over here. I'm still hoping that Hungary will leave this province. There is a chance. Then we will take the siege. Go to Rijssel. In Flemish this is called Rijssel and in French it's called Lille. The city of Lille. It's a nice big city, I would say. We have to click this button twice. Cannot go to Brugge. We need to siege Rijssel first. I'm stuck here with sieging. Let's go here then. It looks like we cannot do anything here. So you can protect trade again. Still have some sailors that can do this for us. Alright, the marketplace in Amsterdam is built, so now we have 22.5. Really? Is it that low only? Yeah. Yeah, the local autonomy modifier is really annoying. And we can only remove this in 67. And the nobility loyalty is high enough. I wonder if we can actually reach that. Yeah. Now there goes Antwerpen. I hope that I can still take Antwerpen. I think I will otherwise start over. Yeah, do this battle over here. It's no problem. Sometimes you can actually capture some ships. It's a lot of sieging Den Haag. That's very funny. Let's keep our relations high with Austria at all times. Maybe they won't demand the land back, but I think they will. I think we can go to speed 4 now. Let's hope Antwerpen will become free again. Hopefully Liège won't take it. So there's the Renaissance. And the Renaissance is well, spreading everywhere. It was in Saluzzo. But the Flemish provinces have a modifier. Flanders, Tuscany and Venetia gets plus 0.75. And this is really close to our land, so we will get it pretty quickly. Okay, we have Rijssel, then I will go here. I will tell my vessels that they should not attach to me anymore. And we have a new heir, and it's a 504. Yeah, alright. It's not terrible. It's an average if I focus on diplo power. I wonder what's gonna happen over here. I'm gonna maintain you. And actually siege down as many things as I can. It's a level 2 fort, but they are getting sieged by someone else, but let's help them out, I guess. Here we go. We will go to stability 1, because that is important for prosperity and the development modifiers. But yeah, we are of course winning like crazy. France should have the highest ward participation, so they wanted some land, and that's fine. We will give them a province. But that's it. Now let's make the clergy happy, I guess. Yeah, I hope we can get the loyalty high enough at some point to get rid of these of that thing there. Gonna be close, I think. Let's put these troops on Antwerpen, that when Liège pieces out, we are sieging it down immediately. You can protect trade again. But you don't want to, because there is a big fleet here. Yeah, that's another siege of Brugge. Help France. Oh. Help France. Go, and we captured 2 transports, and we can sell those. I don't want to use transports at the beginning. And now we have to wait for Liège to peace out. Oh yeah, and we have to set our naval doctrine. So when you play as Portugal or Castile, you have a doctrine that gives you 10% marines. The Netherlands does not have that one, I think. So we will just go for trade power. Don't take Antwerp and Liège. Don't do it. I mean, it's a total victory, as we all knew. Switzerland will be able to peace out soon as well, because we are sieging down Bern. Yeah, we are so reliant on the AI here, we can't do anything else. I'm also gonna set my rivals right now because we are at war. Ooh, easy war here, I think. Okay, can we peace out Switzerland here? And can we get something from Switzerland? Get 25 money. Cancel this. And give me some war apps. And give me some prestige here. There we go. Bye. So I think our force limit is now 10. 9. It's 9. So we have our full force limit here. Can you now protect trade? Yeah, he's protecting trade again. Ooh, Lollards. The risk of trade. We can compensate the burghers, making them more loyal. Gain mercantilism for money, or we piss them off. Let's make the burghers happy. So we get plus 20% trade efficiency again. Now we make even more money. And we have extra mercantilism. Make 5.5 trade. Oh, I don't like it that the AI is just waiting and waiting and waiting. Why are you not peacing out? Let me put one troop on the other province so they cannot recruit. Like this. Yeah. Nothing to do than waiting before we can do all our other things that we need to do. Clergy loses loyalty or gain loyalty. They can lose a bit for prestige, that's fine. And Denmark took all of this. And the Teutonic Order is gonna get wrecked as well. Yeah, there we go. Four provinces left. We lose prestige again. Again. We lost again prestige. And now we have to wait. Let's go to speed 5. Because we need to wait for Liège to peace out. Do the best guess here. How long is it gonna take? Come on! New Pope. Took the institution spread bonus. We are losing innovativeness, really. I always pick this one. We can use the morale. Oh, Liège, you can peace out. Why are you not peacing out? We get a claim on Antwerpen. Yes. Come on, AI. Peace out. Yes, I want to rival you too. Truths are expiring, yes. Call for pizza. We have call for pizza. And the war with Liège was first, so the AI must have call for pizza way longer than me, and they are not peacing out. Amazing. Yes, we will go 10 years ahead in Diplotech here. We will take Well, it doesn't matter, we get new ones, but we take the manpower. They must peace out soon. We can complete a mission. What is it? High income. Construction cost minus 10%. Yes, that's good. We can make our tax, our churches, and our other stuff better. And I think they peaced out. Burgundy will cede Namur to Liège. Brabant will cede Brabant to Liège. Burgundy, okay. And we are fine. And now this is a level 3 fort, because now this is their capital. Okay. That's not helping with the... We need to blockade the coastline here. So when we complete these two, I will ask for Antwerpen. You guys need to go here. Because we need 9,000 troops. Siege down that fort. I don't think I can ask for it now. No. So we need to siege down this this fort here. Let's go to speed 5. Oh my god, this war. This call for pizza is gonna ruin our country as well. What a start again. Well, you know what happens, right? When Dutch is making a recording, you get all this shenanigans. You know it on forehand. I mean, we just need this fort. I want Antwerpen. Okay, it's going quickly now. Quicker now, that's good. Yeah, and we have a disease, and then we need to wait. Oh, we get some help. Good. So it took 13 years to get our start set up. That's a long time. But I will continue. I mean, we did have a good starting leader from Burgundy. Alright, we are gonna go and become independent. We will take Antwerpen, which France doesn't like. But if I give this to France, not enough. Ooh. I don't want to give this to France because that is going to... I can only give one province. I hope France will like us after this, but let's see what happens. We could not give you more, France. I'm sorry. We are gonna rival. Wait, is Brabant free as well? Brabant is a free nation. That's not happening all the time. Gonna protect trade in the English Channel. We are gonna sell you. Do you want some more ships, Denmark? No. England? France, do you want an extra ship? No. Hamburg? Yes. Bremen? Yes, Bremen wants it as well. There we go. Now we have two forts. We'll keep them enabled to get rid of our devastation. We have 26% in Antwerpen. This one can go out. And yeah, we did get the demand lawful territory, unfortunately. I will take this one. We have men at longbows here. And yeah, I think that's going to be it for the first episode here. So thank you all for watching. It was a really slow start, but yeah, we couldn't do anything about it. And at least we are a bit ahead in technology. So please like the video if you like the series. Subscribe to the channel. And I hope to see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.